We are now on the road to WrestleMania. Things are really heating up here in the WWE, but I can't help but think there's something missing, something not quite right.
It's sad that we're on the same wavelength. It must mean that I'm getting older, but I think you're talking about a certain 5'11" beautiful blonde diva by the name of Stacy Keibler. Am I right?
You are correct, sir.
That's right. Stacy has been competing on a show here in the United States called Dancing with the Stars, and every week, Stacy has been blowing the judges away and the audience. Stacy is proving to the world that this diva can dance.
The pressure is on as we begin our third week of competition.
Dancing the tango, Stacy Keibler and her partner Tony Dabalani.
It was definitely the most frustrating dance that I had to learn. For me to be angry and mean and put on that kind of face is tough for me. I'm much more of a very happy, smiley kind of person.
Once she had the supermodel elegance, at the end you had aggression.
That's just like a little shout out to WWE fans who've been amazing supporters of me.
Everything that you do is great. The other women are going to have a hard time competing with you.
Hopefully we won't have to do anything dirty or underhanded, like push her down the stairs or anything like that.
Hold on. Put me in the ring, I'll try to take her out.
I'd be very surprised if one of the other dancers or celebrities came at me.
Like, come out, she's dancing, and I come out with a chair, and I, like, wham.
Oh, come on.
Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight.
Go out here. Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
WrestleMania is running wild.
My God, what a...
Everyone, and welcome to Velocity. Steve Romero alongside Josh Matthews. No way out, just around the corner. Things really heating up on SmackDown.
Please welcome Simon Dean.
And things are heating up here on Velocity, because here comes my man, Simon Dean.
You think he even really likes you?
Of course he does.
Well, I know he doesn't like me, but that's okay.
Nobody does.
That's all right, too.
People, my name is Simon Dean. And a wise man once told me that when a man has a vision that's different from everyone else, he's either insane or he's a genius. So am I insane to think that my boys are going to be the next WWE Tag Team Champions? Or am I a genius because I believe in them? Either way you look at it, as far as I'm concerned, these two men are the first two members of the Church of Simonology. Ladies and gentlemen, my Gemini! Yeah!
And I'll tell you what, you know, Simon Dean, I've got my differences with him, but the fact is, he has uncovered some great talent, and the Gemini have really taken care of anybody that's gotten in their path.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, at a combined weight of 580 pounds, the Gemini.
Products of the Simon System, the Gemini.
Maybe you should take some of that stuff.
I'm a part of the Church of Simonology.
And at a combined weight of 403 pounds, the Rocky.
And Funaki and Scotty Too Hotty, and they're going to need something on their side to deal with the Gemini. So Simon Dean's boys, the Gemini, taking on Scotty Too Hotty and Funaki.
I don't even know who to give the advantage to in this match as far as speed goes, because I think the Gemini may have the speed advantage over Scotty Too Hotty and Funaki. Obviously, the Gemini has a strength advantage. I think the Gemini's got it across the board. sport.
Yeah, they may have the speed, in fact. Quickness, however, I will go with Scotty Too Hotty and Funaki. And they're going to need a boatload of it.
Your opinion means nothing.
Well, that's all right. It does to me. That's all that matters. You think I actually stand there in the morning thinking I've got to impress Josh Matthews?
And you know, Scotty Too Hotty and Funaki have to pay attention to Simon Dean on the outside and that whistle.
Yeah, that whistle is kind of like Simon Dean in general. Obnoxious.
Simon mentioned the Church of Simonology, which I am a member of. I'm also a member of a lot of things. I like to knit sometimes. I'm a member of a group called the Knitwits.
Do you actually get a card that says, I'm a member of the Church of Simonology?
There's no card.
You don't understand. How do you get in the back door?
You don't understand.
Oh, look at that. Schoolboy quickly by Funaki. Funaki getting off to that quick start side headlock. Tag here by Scotty Too Hotty, and I guess it's a legal tag.
Sure, Scotty Too Hotty touched a part of Funaki, enabling a legal tag, and now Scotty Too Hotty. This is what Scotty and Funaki are going to need to do is keep Gemini on their toes, keep each other fresh, and maybe they'll have a chance to win this match.
Hey, I'll tell you what, Gemini needs to get a victory, keep on their roll. Eventually, they want a shot at the WWE Tag Team Champions, and right now, that is M&M. And this past week on SmackDown, M&M issued an open challenge to any team who wanted to come out for their supposed 15 minutes of fame.
Yeah, and then out came Brian Kendrick and Paul London, and the WWE Tag Team Champions, after a back-and-forth match, took care of Kendrick and London 15 minutes.
Well, it was a non-title match, but I'll tell you what, Brian Kendrick and Paul London looked very well on their way to winning that match until one of your favorites, Melina, interjected, as she always seems to do, in perfect timing.
Now, that's why Melina's boys, M&M, are the WWE Tag Team Champions, and in my opinion, they'll remain the Tag Team Champions for quite some time.
Tag made by Gemini, and right now Scotty Too Hotty gets covered. The count to two, and Scotty able to kick out. But right now, the Gemini doing anything and everything they would like to do.
Pure power in the ring right now by the Gemini. Each of these men are just monstrous superstars, and they're on the Simon system, which makes them maybe triple times more dangerous than any other superstar on the roster.
Look at this. As usual, the snake Simon Dean with the referee distracted. A quick shot to Scotty Too Hotty just to interject his two cents. Oh, Scotty Too Hotty pounded to the canvas.
A big peel out of the corner there.
The cover here to two. This could be a no. Scotty Too Hotty able to kick out. I'll tell you what, M&M has got to have their eyes on Gemini, as does any other tag team in the WWE.
Well, M&M are the WWE Tag Team Champions, so I'm sure they're watching every tag team match that happens on SmackDown and Velocity.
Right now, Scotty in the middle of the ring, unable to make the tag to Funaki, and he needs to do so. Scotty worn out, and the Gemini right now enjoying the fact that Scotty's got not much in the tank.
This is the predicament that Scotty Too Hotty did not want to be in. Worn down in the middle of the ring, off of his feet, allowing the Gemini, and you can see how the Gemini here has all his weight on the back of Scotty Too Hotty, and that hurts just as much as having that arm wrapped around your neck.
Scotty trying to rally a bit, a couple of elbows to the midsection, but Scotty tripped up coming off those ropes. And they're covered here by Gemini. Count to two. Oh, and one more time I count to two. Gemini right now almost toying with Scotty Too Hotty.
That was a tight cover there, and Scotty Too Hotty using all of his strength, all of his energy, everything he's got left to kick out. Scotty Too Hotty desperately needs to get out of this match.
I'll give the Gemini credit. They listen to everything Simon Dean does, and I think Simon Dean just getting off on the fact that there's a bit of torture to Scotty Too Hotty.
When you're on the Simon system, you got to listen to Simon Dean.
I guess. The cover here on Scotty. And boy, Scotty Too Hotty right now, close to being out of this match. And he needs a tag desperately, but nowhere close.
And again, Scotty Too Hotty off his feet in the Gemini's half of the ring. Just worn down. Simon Dean, he looks concerned, but Simon's boys are in full control right now.
We are just at the beginning of a big show. We will see Lashley a bit later. We're starting you off here with Gemini, and right now in full control of Scotty Too Hotty and Funaki.
I can't wait to see Lashley here on Velocity.
Each and every week, Lashley seems to be getting better and better and destructive. He does it quickly. Scotty Too Hotty, I think, wishes this would end quickly, because right now, taking abuse and punishment, trying to rally out of this and somehow get a tag.
Well, the fans in this arena here, Scotty Juhani feeding off them, back to his feet. Scotty needs to break this side headlock and ducks.
Scotty off the ropes and comes downstairs with a boot. That bought him some time. Perhaps Scotty needed to get that tag and really didn't try for it.
Here we go. Here we go.
Here's the opportunity. He takes advantage of it. Funaki, full of energy and in the ring, off the ropes and a big elbow.
This will be a victory for Funaki if he can get the Gemini off his feet.
Oh, and there it is. Funaki, it's like moving a mountain, but Funaki somehow gets the Gemini off his feet. I tell you what, Simon Dean, that whistle, how annoying. The cover by Funaki. Gemini comes in to save his partner. The boot from Scotty Tuhati, and one of the Gemini goes flying outside the ring.
Well, keep in mind that Funaki and this Gemini are the legal men in this matchup.
Maybe that's what we ought to call them, this Gemini and that Gemini.
Oh, you call them that.
Thank you. Uh-oh, oh, trying the DDT off the second rope to no avail for Funaki.
And Funaki tripped up there in the corner and hit hard off that turnbuckle.
Yeah, Funaki looks a bit dazed. And the cover here, he's been down, and I guess he is now out. Funaki not able to kick out.
Gemini!
Dazed and confused coming off that... out of that corner, Josh.
And the Gemini hit the cross trainer on Funaki. Simon Dean says he's a genius. He's found the next WWE Tag Team Champion.
Still to come on Velocity, the ruthless Kid Cash faces psychosis in cruiserweight singles action.
But first, who will earn an opportunity at the United States Championship? Velocity has the answers when we come back.
This past week, Matt Hardy, Chris Benoit, Orlando Jordan, and JBL battled it out in a fatal four-way to determine who would face Booker T for the United States Championship. Time for Tatanka! Originally made headlines here in the WWE going almost 2 years. 2 years without losing. Impressive.
And now we'll see what Tatanka can do against Jock Bliskin. I guess Tony Chimmel's never seen the word Jock before, and he called him Jakeus, but that's Tony Chimmel.
So are you going with Jock or Jakeus?
Jock. It's a French name.
Okay.
Guy's been on Velocity before. Tony Chimmel should know this, but he's an idiot.
I don't think Tony Chimmel's going to like that very much. Tatanka starting off fast and furious. And, you know, being the Sultan of Fashion here on Velocity, I like Tatanka's gear. I like how he looks.
Great.
Good color, you know.
Thundering chop there by Tatanka. No doubt about it, Tatanka, an in-ring veteran. And Jock Bliskin better have done his homework because Tatanka will bring it.
Yeah, Bliskin definitely will need everything he can to survive in this match. Tatanka ruthless and will do what it takes to get the victory, and has certainly been impressive since returning here to the WWE. Bliskin tossed into the corner and then the boot downstairs.
Wow. A delayed vertical suplex there.
Bliskin's lower back taking a big shot right there. That can hammer a disc or two.
And you see that Tatanka, no wasted movement inside that ring. Tatanka is in that ring to do business. That's to beat Jock Bliskin.
that left shoulder and arm of Pliskin doing damage. I tell you what, no way out coming up, and it's right upon us, Josh. It should be outstanding.
No doubt about it. No way out's going to be absolutely off the chain. I personally cannot wait. World Heavyweight Championship on the line. Kurt Angle, virtually unstoppable. The man is a wrestling machine. He's got to take down the Phenom, the Dead Man, the Undertaker. Who knows what's going to happen?
And how about Randy Orton taking on Rey Mysterio? 2 weeks ago, Orton reaching a new low, disrespecting the memory of Eddie Guerrero, making incredibly disparaging marks about the beloved superstar.
Well, Randy Orton, obviously, what he said was completely uncalled for. Randy Orton just trying to get underneath the skin of Rey Mysterio, trying to get Mysterio to put that WrestleMania title opportunity on the line in a match. Orton got what he wanted. I mean, we know it, no way out. It will be Orton Mysterio. Mysterio's WrestleMania title opportunity will hang in the balance. But Randy Orton continued to say negative things about the life of Eddie Guerrero.
And I'll tell you what, Randy Orton got under Ray's skin and did exactly what Randy Orton does, annoy people, getting them to the point where they want to bust. Rey Mysterio fought for a new record at the Royal Rumble to get the Royal Rumble victory and to get that opportunity at WrestleMania. And Randy Orton calculating and it really miserably got his way, got Rey to put this title shot on the line.
That's what Eddie Guerrero means to Rey Mysterio. I mean, just imagine what a championship opportunity means to Mysterio, and now Mysterio's putting that opportunity on the line to take care of business against the legend killer, Randy Orton.
That speaks volumes. Pliskin with the cover here on Tatanka. The count to two, Tatanka able to kick out. Also at No Way Out, Booker T versus Chris Benoit. Many people feel Benoit should be the United States champion. He now gets his shot. Booker T cannot run, cannot hide. There may be no way out. No doctor's notes. Nothing will keep Booker T out of the ring against Chris Benoit.
Yep. And about says it all. I don't know what else to say. You took every adjective in the book and you applied it to that match, so I'll just lay out.
Well, good. It's all right. Sometimes that's all right, isn't it?
Not really.
Tatanka off the rope. Pliskin swings and misses. Tatanka comes back and a big shot. And right now, Pliskin just taking all kinds of abuse.
And this is Tatanka just stalking Jack Pliskin right now.
Back body drop by Tatanka. He's getting fired up.
That's that Native American battle cry. This is a Native American dance. I think it might start raining in the arena.
And it's raining chops right there as Pliskin goes down like a ton of bricks one more time. Pliskin trying to figure out where he's at. Wow, the power displayed by Tatanka, and Pliskin doing all he can to stay in this match, and he's done so, but how long will that last?
Oh. That's the trail's end for Jack Pliskin.
And that indeed is the end for Pliskin.
Here's your winner, Tatanka.
It's the end of the trail. The trail's end. That Samoan drop by Tatanka. Tatanka is back in the WWE. And I tell you what, Tatanka made noise in the Royal Rumble match. Tatanka's making some serious noise here on Velocity. A big time win for this WWE superstar named Tatanka.
I'm right here in Tokyo. This is a district called Akihabara. People friendly. West Side.
They are waiting for you at the airports. They're waiting for you at the hotel.
The enthusiasm level of the Japanese fans is always a fever pitch.
Green light.
Welcome to Yokohama!
This is the first time I've been to Asia. I'm really looking forward to going out there performing in front of this crowd.
I love WWE.
It's a nice atmosphere out here, man. I'm loving it. They love the American people to come over and feel their culture, feel their atmosphere.
I'm actually the biggest thing to be here since Godzilla, our King Kong. Some Japanese people have gotten that wrong. They're calling me a wrestling Buddha. But either way, I'm enlightened.
They treat us like royalty here, and I appreciate that. That's really good.
Tell you what, another successful tour by the SmackDown superstars to the Far East. They certainly enjoyed it. Hey, how about this? Bobby Lashley is enjoying life right now. His opponent's not.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall approaching the ring from Colorado Springs, Colorado, weighing in at 273 pounds, Bobby Lashley.
Bobby Lashley, big as a mountain and as strong as they come. Don't forget, Bobby Lashley was my pick to win the Royal Rumble match. Yeah, I got a lot of stock in Bobby Lashley. And rightly so, you should. Bobby Lashley has been spectacular.
And weighing in at 215 pounds, James.
Wait, does this mean we're not going to get a dance by the Dicks?
I love to see the dance. Where's the dance?
I know everyone out there watch Velocity loves to see the Dicks dance.
Unfortunately, I guess that will not happen. Perhaps not in a dancing mood. I mean, if you were going to face Bobby Lashley, would you be in a dancing mood? Probably not.
I'd dance my way right out of the arena if I was this Dick.
Dance in, dance out. Bobby Lashley, the big news coming from SmackDown this past week. He will take on JBL at No Way Out.
After JBL lost that fatal four-way match, the winner, of course, Chris Benoit, now the number one contender for the United States Championship. JBL was very upset. JBL in the back, walking around. Out comes Bobby Lashley, challenges JBL for the match, and it was Julian Hall who accepted.
JBL droning on how he can take on anybody. Look at the height of that big back body drop by Lashley. And as JBL was going on, Bobby Lashley
Chad
walked
Dick.
Up.
Chad Dick's about to get his.
Chad Dick apparently looking for a miracle, looking into the mirror, and Chad Dick got Lashley off guard to go fail.
Let the Dicks hit the floor.
The power, unbelievable by Lashley. Taking no prisoner.
Oh, there's Dicks flying all over the arena.
James Dick right now getting a beating by Bobby Lashley.
All the blood rushing to the head of that Dick, and this vertical suplex is going to do some serious damage.
Look at this, one-handed Lashley in firm control of James Dick. Lashley picking his spot, perhaps envisioning JBL.
I tell you what, Lashley's got the power too. He can hold JBL up in that vertical delayed suplex. He can spear the self-proclaimed wrestling god, and he can definitely dominate him.
Look at the move, look at the power. And that should be end of story for James Dick. And it is. Tell you what, JBL has his hands full. He was less than enthusiastic about facing Lashley, and it's almost upon us.
Tell you what, JBL's a former WWE champion, but the wrestling god better watch out. The Lashley experience is rolling and in No Way Out.
Mark Henry said he will do to The Undertaker what he did to Batista. He will take The Undertaker out, and he will become the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. Coming up next, it is the world's strongest man versus the Phenom. Can't wait, can't wait.
This past week, The Undertaker made his in-ring return to SmackDown as the Phenom faced the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Gregory Helms able to retain the Cruiserweight Championship this past week. He will have a lot of suitors for that title, including this man.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring, weighing in at 200 pounds, Kid Cash.
Well, Kid Cash was never pinned in that Cruiserweight Invitational at the Royal Rumble, so Kid Cash is using his rematch clause this week on SmackDown. Kid Cash, Gregory Helms, the Cruiserweight Championship of the World.
It seems pretty obvious that you people clearly don't know who I am. Because if you did, you'd be on your feet giving me the ovation that I deserve. So one more time, for those who didn't hear the introduction, I am the notorious K.I.D. Kid Cash, and I am the greatest cruiserweight of all time. And not one of you even deserves to be looking in my direction.
Wow.
Get it?
Para toda mi gente mexicana.
Kid Cash has a very high opinion of himself.
And making his way to the ring, weighing in at 202 pounds, is a member of the Mexico Rajkute.
Well, Kid Cash better not be looking ahead to this upcoming week on SmackDown, where Cash will challenge Gregory Helms, as I mentioned, for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World. Cash better pay attention to psychosis right here, right now, on Velocity.
That is correct. The best all-round Cruiserweight, psychosis. He can do it all.
And a very cocky Kid Cash. Not that that differs from any other one. All the greatest cruiserweights in the world are here in the WWE, and Kid Cash claims to be the greatest of the greatest. However, Gregory Helms is the cruiserweight champion.
Psychosis honoring the late great Eddie Guerrero with the armband. Kid Cash honoring nobody.
Look at his verbal repertoire. Unbelievable with the word shut up. Way to go, Kid. Well, Kid Cash knows that no one should be looking in his direction, but fortunately, we have to look in his direction so we can call the match.
Exactly.
And referee Jimmy Corderas has to look in his direction, and the cameraman here in the arena.
So you're saying that Kid Cash is pretty much off base.
I'm saying that Kid Cash isn't going to get what he wishes he will get.
Kid Cash starting quickly. Psychosis off the ropes.
And you know the Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Gregory Helms, is keeping an eye on this match, knowing he has to face Kid Cash this week on SmackDown for the Cruiserweight Championship. You know, Gregory Helms made history at the Royal Rumble.
A fairly solid move, I would say. Gregory Helms coming into place where the Cruiserweight, well, the only place you can see the Cruiserweight on the SmackDown brand.
That's right, and Gregory Helms is at the top of the mountain, and he will have to try to knock Kid Cash down this upcoming week on SmackDown. I can't wait.
Kid Cash, ruthless. He is a warrior. He will do anything he can to regain that Cruiserweight Championship. But right now, has got to be concerned with psychosis. We'll give Kid Cash everything he wants and more. The nimbleness of psychosis. There.
Well, don't blink, because this match will be high-flying and fast-paced for sure.
Ooh, Kid Cash coming off the ropes, gets caught by Psychosis, who slams Cash to the canvas. The cover here to two. Kid Cash able to get that left shoulder up. I'll tell you what, a lot to look forward to this week on SmackDown, Josh. A three-on-two handicap match. The Undertaker and Kurt Angle. Sounds strange. Oh, as Psychosis gets rammed into the post. Versus the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, and the WWE Tag Team Champions, Eminem.
Well, first of all, it's a three-on-two handicap match. And second of all, the two men who will be competing for the World Heavyweight Championship at No Way Out, Kurt Angle and The Undertaker, are going to be partners. How are Kurt Angle and The Undertaker going to coexist as a tag team, knowing that they'll be battling for the World Heavyweight Championship at No Way Out?
Certainly an unlikely tag team. I mean, you wouldn't expect to see that. And that's what makes the WWE great.
And it's basically a four-on-two handicap, because you know that Melina will be outside watching her boys and the world's strongest man, Mark Henry. As a matter of fact, it'll probably be five-on-two, because Daivari will be there too.
Yeah, that's a good point, and I hate to say it. Your hair's covering it up, but good point.
What happened?
Nothing. You missed it.
Did you try to tell a joke? And I missed it?
Small one.
Oh, man.
It doesn't happen very often.
Was it funny?
I digress. Kid Cash right now hammering away on Psychosis to that right arm. Left arm, that is. Left, man, right, whatever.
It's one of his arms, right?
It's one of his arms. He's only got two. You can see which one it is. And Cash, here's the ruthless part about Cash. We'll just get in. He'll kick you. He will do
scratch, claw, anything he can do to get a victory.
Well, Kid Cash finds a body part, and he just pinpoints that, and he will systematically dissect his opponents, and that's exactly what he's doing to Psychosis right now.
Right now, using the hair, then a snapmare. And Psychosis right now, feeling the wrath of Kid Cash.
Kid Cash, definitely a triple threat. Obviously, he's a high flyer. He can counter anything you throw at him. What people know, Kid Cash, he can wrestle. He can get on the mat, and he can wrestle you, and that's exactly what he's doing to Psychosis right now. And he's got a handful of hair.
Gregory Helms taking notes as Kid Cash right now battling Psychosis. Kid Cash, not a whole lot of weaknesses when it comes to it. I mean, the bottom line is he comes back from just about everything and dishes out everything and more to his opposition. Cash, the cover here on Psychosis. Psychosis able to catch the rope. Referee Jimmy Corderas doesn't even begin the count.
And Kid Cash going right back to that shoulder of Psychosis.
He's been working on that shoulder since the beginning of this match, and it certainly has affected Psychosis. You can feel him, see him favoring that shoulder. And that won't help any. The count to two. Psychosis able to get out, and right there, Josh, you see Psychosis really holding on to that left shoulder.
And every single move that Kid Cash is using in this match is going after that shoulder of Psychosis.
Cash showboating a bit. Psychosis uses the opportunity to battle back. A shot to the breadbasket, then going upstairs to Kid Cash. Psychosis ducks, then flies off the ropes. Perhaps a bit of a momentum swing here in favor of Psychosis. Kid Cash right now wondering where he's at following that heel kick.
Well, as long as Psychosis has two good legs, you better watch out.
The crowd coming alive behind Psychosis, trying to help urge him on to a victory over Kid Cash. Oh! The spinning kick off the top rope by Psychosis hit in a brilliantly timed. The cover here by Psychosis almost hit 2.5.
And Psychosis couldn't get all of that cover due to the fact that his shoulder's been beaten up this entire match by Kid Cash.
You gotta wonder what Psychosis has left. I mean, right now he's pretty much out there fighting with one arm, and you can see that left arm dangle down below his waist. Psychosis able to springboard up. Kid Cash misses and goes face first into the corner. Oh, man, Cash just continues to hammer away. The cover here, the count to two, and no.
Tell you what, Kid Cash would have had this match won had Psychosis been completely on his back there, but a great call by referee Jimmy Corderas, realizing that both of Psychosis' shoulders weren't on the mat.
And right now, Kid Cash says he's going to end things. Will he do it? Not right now. A great counter by Psychosis.
Both of these men know each other so well.
Psychosis the cover here, and he can't lock up because of that left shoulder.
Psychosis needed to hook the leg there, and Psychosis may have won this match. Imagine what it'll do to the ego of Kid Cash if he loses the match before he's going to face Gregory Helms for the Cruiserweight Championship this week on SmackDown.
Yeah, that cannot be a good thing. Psychosis now making his way to that top rope. Wow. Flexibility and a great move off the top rope, but to no avail. And Psychosis gets nothing but canvas.
Corkscrew, that's why they call it high risk, because sometimes you miss. And now Kid Cash with a brain buster.
Look at that move by Kid Cash. It tightens it up, and there it is.
Here's your winner, Kid Cash.
Will this be the scene this week on SmackDown when Kid Cash takes on Gregory Helms for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World? We'll find out. He's Josh Matthews. I'm Steve Romero. We'll talk to you next week. Hello, everyone. No Way Out is almost upon us.
so many great matches cannot wait. Steve Romero alongside Josh Matthews with this edition of Velocity.
Following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall approaching the ring at a combined weight of 430 pounds. Chad and James, the Dick.
Hey, a tremendous edition of Velocity on tap for you. We got the Dicks as well as Paul London and Brian Kendrick. And how about some cruiserweight action as well?
Oh, yeah, no way out upon us and nothing that my partner Steve Romero likes more than a couple of dicks.
You know, you're a real funny guy. You know there are comedians out of work. You're trying to be funny.
You're going to get to see the Dicks dance here. You should be thrilled. No Way Out is here. Everyone knows that No Way Out is going to be absolutely off the hook. And you get to watch the Dicks dance.
Hey, you know, I think the guy's got some talent. I don't know if I'd go as far with this mirror thing and the sparkles. I do admire the red, however.
This is like Christmas for you.
Yeah, I'm securing my masculinity that I can appreciate, you know, a good outfit and just good things that other people have.
Okay.
You know, I'm not bitter all the time, unlike you. Really, Cam, I mean, you can dance like that, can't you?
Got a few moves.
Former Chippendale, no?
And at a combined weight of 361 pounds, Paul London and Brian Kendrick.
Well, no doubt about this, Josh. We're going to have some high-flying action as the risk-takers, Paul London and Brian Kendrick, taking on the Dicks.
Yeah, two guys who don't dance, Paul London and Brian Kendrick, all these guys do is wrestle, and they do it just as good as anybody.
And both high flyers will have a shot at the Cruiserweight Championship at No Way Out.
That's right. Thanks to our general manager, Theodore Long, Gregory Helms will put his Cruiserweight Championship of the World on the line against every single Cruiserweight on the SmackDown roster at No Way Out. It is going to be awesome. I can't wait to see what goes down. Sudden death.
Gregory Helms recently coming over from Raw and getting that Cruiserweight Championship has been arrogant, insulting the other Cruiserweights. And said that he can do just about anything. This past week on SmackDown, in fact, had to defend his championship against Scotty Too Hotty and did survive.
Yeah, I tell you what, though, Gregory Helms, he can back it up. I mean, he made history at the Royal Rumble, coming over winning the Cruiserweight Championship Invitational, and he's been defending the Cruiserweight Championship successfully on SmackDown. We'll see if Gregory Helms can escape No Way Out.
I'll tell you what, after Scotty Too Hotty lost to the new Cruiserweight champ, I tell you what, Helms had to endure moves from every single cruiserweight in the division, and he took some punishment.
Well, the cruiserweights on SmackDown, you know, aren't really appreciative of Gregory Helms going around saying that he's the greatest cruiserweight champion of all time. So the cruiserweights did something about it, and then our general manager did something about it, and we'll see what goes down at No Way Out.
Should be high-flying action, just one of the great matches coming up at No Way Out. Right now, the Dicks taking on the team of Brian Kendrick and Paul London. The tag man here and James Dick getting ready to come into the ring. And the Dick's getting fired up. You love that.
I think James is a little apprehensive about getting in the ring with Brian Kendrick.
The tassels on the boots are a nice touch though, huh?
I don't really like the tassels.
No, don't like them?
I don't think they're going to do anything for him.
Yeah, you may be right there. Oh, the big knee to Brian Kendrick. Kendrick down on the canvas, working his way up. Oh, an attempted scoop slam didn't go, but Kendrick and London come back, and a couple of kicks. London with the cover here. Count to two, and James able to kick out.
Well, my opinion is Brian Kendrick and Paul London are two of the most exciting athletes on SmackDown. Their offense is calculated chaos. They will bring it out sometime in this matchup, and the Dicks won't know what hit them.
You know, I hate to agree with, but I'll tell you what, watching Paul London and Brian Kendrick, certainly a joy. These guys, high flyers, risk takers, and do whatever it takes to win.
I wonder what's going to happen at No Way Out. Brian Kendrick and Paul London both vying for the Cruiserweight Championship of the World, and you know as well as I do how much the Kendrick and London would love to be Cruiserweight champions. So, you know, what's going to happen if they have to square off against each other at No Way Out?
That great question, and right now Paul London concerned with the Dicks, and just London has his attention taken away from James Dick and a cheap shot by Chad.
And this is what the Dicks are going to need to do in this matchup: use a two-on-one assault.
Cover here on London, count to one. London able to kick out. Ooh, London takes one right in the chest in the sternum area. Watching two of the great tag teams on the SmackDown roster go at it, and there will be tag team action at No Way Out as Eminem in action.
That's right, Eminem has their open challenge issued by Molina to any two superstars on the SmackDown roster. Matt Hardy approached Molina this past week and said, hey, I'm up for the challenge. Now the big question is, who will Matt Hardy's partner be at No Way Out as he takes on Eminem?
I'm dying to find out that one, because Matt Hardy already half a great tag team. Whoever he gets, it's going to be a great competition against Eminem, but the surprise guest, the surprise tag team partner, should be great to find out who that's going to be.
Yeah, Matt Hardy, he knows all too well about tag team wrestling, a former WWE tag team champion, one half of the Hardy Boys with his brother Jeff. So whoever Matt brings in at No Way Out, it is going to be electrifying, and I can't wait to see what goes down.
You know, I can't believe it. I actually have another compliment for you, because it comes so few and far between, but I think your new nickname ought to be the Encyclopedia. Oh, that's so much information.
I know a lot of stuff. I'm not going to lie about that.
Some of it's worthless, but when it comes to wrestling, you do know a lot of stuff.
That's true.
Back to the ring. Paul London right now in a precarious situation, trying to get to a vertical base.
I think one of that Dix is busted open.
Hey, it looks like he is busted open. I don't know. Right now, London showing tremendous strength in the middle of the ring, trying to go over and grab the tag. Kendrick. James comes in with the
kick.
London with the tag, exactly. Kendrick comes in, and he should be full of energy.
The tag's not going to count because referee Nick Patrick never saw it happen.
Didn't see the tag. A shame for the team of London and Kendrick, because it was legal.
Every single person in this arena saw that tag except for Nick Patrick, and he's the only one that matters.
Oh, London comes back with a great counter.
And now London on the right side of the ring. No one between Paul London and Brian Kendrick. Can Paul London make this tag?
Both superstars down on the canvas.
Here we go.
And the kick stops again, trying the cheap shots, but flooded with the tag, and Kendrick, all kinds of energy. Ooh, drop kick. And then another. Brian Kendrick coming in on fire. The Dicks trying to double team, but it's not working. Look at the teamwork by Paul London and Brian Kendrick.
Paul London slingshotting Brian Kendrick right into the Dicks, and here we go.
Oh, Brian Kendrick up and over, but nobody home. Paul London spins out of the way, and James Dick comes. Oh, Kendrick moves just in time. And we got everything breaking down here.
Oh, the Dicks are all over the place.
Oh! Oh, my God! Paul London off the bottom rope comes out. I don't know how to describe that. Unbelievable. Kendrick was slight threat number two. And there it is. What a finish. Paul London and Brian Kendrick hold on to defeat the Dicks, who did everything to cheat to get the victory. But the talented duo, the high-flying duo of London and Kendrick come out with a win. And Josh, you've seen a lot of wrestling. Look at this move.
Now you talk about high risk and putting your body on the line. Check this out. Shooting star press by Paul London off the back of Chad Dick right onto James Dick, allowing Brian Kendrick to hit slice spread number two. And that's why those two men right there are standing in the ring victorious after this tag team matchup. Will Paul London or Brian Kendrick be victorious at No Way Out when the Cruiserweight Championship is on the line?
Still to come before battling it out for the Cruiserweight Championship at No Way Out. Nunzio and Super Crazy will go one-on-one right here on Velocity.
But first, Rey Mysterio goes up against the self-absorbed supermodel Still Bomb, just days before his emotional match against the legend killer Randy Orton at No Way Out.
And wow, what a night it will be, the weekend of WrestleMania's Bret Hart being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame.
That's right, the excellence of execution getting his well-deserved spot in the WWE Hall of Fame. I know a lot of people have been waiting a long time to see Bret the Hitman Hart enter the WWE Hall of Fame.
Should be outstanding right now. We've got Taka He will be taking on Scott Matthews. Tatanka making his surprise return at the Royal Rumble and has been on a roll ever since.
That's right. We saw Tatanka last week right here on Velocity, victorious. Now he's got a tomahawk and he's got the head thing on. He's ready to go.
Hey, I'm just curious. Not that I've seen Scott Matthews. I saw a quick glimpse of him, but he's not your brother or relative or, you know, long-lost cousin.
A lot of people out there that try to adopt my name. You tried to do it when you first came here, and they want to be like me. And I kind of take it, you know, as a compliment. You know, what's the saying? That old cliche.
Yeah,
you're old. What's that cliche? Flattery is
the... I don't know, but, you know, I'm a little more too tan to use the word Matthews. But, you know.
Imitation is the serious... You know how it goes.
Yeah, imitation is flattering. There you go.
There you go.
Yeah, I mean, since that thing has been around for a long time, I figured I'd know it, huh?
I figure you invented it.
Yeah, there you go. Tatanka right here just abusing Mr. Matthews, something I'd like to do.
Yeah, that's good.
That's all you got?
For your first attempt at humor in over 2 years? Yeah, that's all I got.
I'm a lot more funny than you are.
Taking me by surprise, you know?
Every now and then. Back to the ring to Tatanka right now. A couple of boots to the solar plexus of Mr. Matthews. Tatanka right now in control of this match, tossing Matthews into that turnbuckle and face first onto the canvas.
Tatanka, like I said last week, has been in this business for quite some time. He is a veteran, and you're gonna have to bring your lunch when you get inside the ring with Tatanka.
Talk about veterans and bringing your lunch. How about it? No Way Out. An emotional match for Rey Mysterio as he takes on the legend killer Randy Orton. And I'll tell you what, there is a lot on the line.
Well, Rey Mysterio is putting his main event opportunity, his spot at WrestleMania. Rey Mysterio is going to WrestleMania unless he loses to Randy Orton at No Way Out. There's more than a lot on the line. That's on the line. All the emotion riding into this match for Mysterio. Everything for Eddie Guerrero, Rey's best friend. That's why Rey is putting this World Heavyweight Championship opportunity on the line at No Way Out against Randy Orton.
Not only that, Eddie's nephew Chavo Guerrero will be there, as well as Eddie's wife Vicky at ringside to support Rey Mysterio.
And you know that Mysterio is going to be fired up. There is nothing left for Rey Mysterio. Everything's there. All the emotion is there. He wants to beat Randy Orton. Randy Orton has said disparaging things about the life of Eddie Guerrero, Rey Mysterio's best friend, and the winner is going to go on to WrestleMania. I can't wait for No Way Out.
It's going to be an electrifying night, I'll tell you that. Right now, Tatanka taking some punishment. Matthews turning the tables a bit.
Tatanka is feeding off of this. See, right now, Tatanka's getting fired up. It's what Native Americans do. I've studied Native American tribes my entire life, and this is what they do.
Encyclopedia, I should have never said that. Tatanka with that chop, laying Matthews out flat.
You can see Tatanka now just stalking Scott Matthews.
Enjoying the moment, if you will. Line him up and set him down. Big shot to the head of Scott Matthews. And now Tatanka really getting it upbeat.
And this is that Native American dance right now by Tatanka. The end may be near for Scott Matthews.
Sounds like a bit of thunder. Matthews just beginning to redden. He's taking serious shots. Matthews right now doing all he can, trying to grab that rope to help him up, but Tatanka will help him up. Big back body drop by Tatanka. But this is a large man that's got a lot of quickness as well.
And Tatanka up to the top of the reservation, and there's the tomahawk chop.
Matthews looks out on his feet. His eyes rolling in the back of his head, and Tatanka now finishing it up. The count to two, and there's three.
Here's your winner, Tatanka.
That was the end of the trail for Scott Matthews. Tatanka, 2 weeks in a row now, victorious on Velocity. Tatanka's back in a big-time way, and I tell you what, watch your scalp.
Booker T going to join us on commentary, because coming up next for the first time ever, Chris Benoit teams with Bobby Lashley versus JBL and Finley, a huge tag team matchup.
Welcome back, and how about this? We get the opportunity for the first time the junior division has appeared on the line.
ferocity. This is what I'm talking about.
Bowling Jr.'s match is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, standing 4 feet, 1 inch tall, weighing in at 100 pounds, Mascarita Zabretta.
Look at the springs off the bottom rope, no problem.
That's right, Mascarita Zabretta. This is going to be an outstanding competition.
Ooh, I love the music.
And standing 4 feet, 2 inches tall, weighing in at 112 pounds, Octagon Cito.
So it will be Octagon Cito and Mascarita Zabretta. I'll tell you what, these two with a lot of talent, it should be great.
And we can thank Palmer Cannon for bringing the juniors to SmackDown and Velocity. It's the first time we've seen them on Velocity. I'm so excited to have the juniors here.
I tell you what, Palmer Cannon with the, you know, his brainchild comes up with a great idea. And by the way, the juniors,
That's good stuff.
You love that, don't you?
Oh, man.
Oh, nice punch. It's still going. Referee Charles Robinson will be overseeing this match.
Ooh, Octagon Cito is giving Mascarita a free shot.
It's almost like a dance from the knees. Oh, where they lock up. Oh!
A
little trickery there going downstairs. It's Zabretta.
That, my friends, is chicanery at its best.
Look at the mask. I love the mask. You know, I always like the Rey Mysterio mask, but these guys, look at that. You'd like to get one of those, wouldn't you?
I got a bunch of them.
Oh! Octagon Cito with the elbow.
Cover!
And the cover here counts to two.
I know a lot about the juniors, obviously, and Octagon Cito is one of my favorites. I hope he wins this match.
I say, Zabretta, famous in Latin America for his mask. Children idolize him, come to the matches with his mask on. The cover here.
That was a short arm clothesline. Get it?
Yeah, you're right
short
there.
Clothesline.
Short arm, I got it. It takes a while. The synapses are now firing. Funny. Ha ha. Nobody home. Octagon Cito comes up empty. Zabretta off the rope. Look at this. Wow. Unbelievable, the head scissors.
What's going on up there?
That's the roof. Referee Charles Robinson,
is that a leak?
Well, okay. Ceiling?
The arena. Arena's going to have roofs.
Okay, what covers it?
The top.
This encyclopedia. The top. I don't know what is going on. Oh! Apparently, nothing. The two training shots trying to get the best of each other, both with comedy and physicality.
This is strategy. Look at this.
Oh! Look at one while the other is coming. Certainly entertaining. Charles Robinson now wondering what's going on. Octagon Cito taking a little chop.
Hey, you don't want to mess with Charles Robinson.
No, Charles has got a nasty streak to him. Takes another shot, this time from Octagon Cito.
Octagon Cito is begging not to be disqualified.
Charles Robinson, I guess, doesn't like to be the butt of a joke.
Oh, a torture rack here.
Look at the strength. Oh!
A torture rack into a TKO by Octagon Cito.
Oh, Octagon Cito coming off the ropes, trying to finish things up, can't do it. Oh, look at the strength there.
Ah, he's brought cradle.
Oh, there it is. What an execution of the strong cradle. Mascarita Zabretta.
Here's your winner, Mascarita Zabretta.
Hey, referee Charles Robinson actually lifting Mascarita Zabretta in the air as he is victorious. The juniors are welcome anytime on Velocity.
You've got to ask the question, can Undertaker and Kurt Angle trust one another?
Well, it seems like Undertaker might be trying to, you know, show Kurt Angle this is how it's done. Trying to one-up each other here, and unfortunately, Eminem is getting the brunt of it.
All right, time for the main event on Velocity. Cruiserweight action.
tentacles will be super crazy taking on Nunzio.
And both Super Crazy and Nunzio will be competing for the Cruiserweight Championship at No Way Out. Each for a chance to take the title from Gregory Hill. As will Psychosis.
You like this jam, don't you?
I've been in my car. Play it sometimes.
Oh, I know you're probably like an honorary Mexico. They probably gave you a copy of CD, didn't they?
Of course.
You know, earlier in the show, Josh, we talked about risk takers and Paul London and Brian Kendrick in this Cruiserweight division. Super Crazy, every bit as talented and high flying.
Oh, no doubt about it. It wouldn't surprise anybody if Super Crazy or Psychosis left No Way Out with the Cruiserweight Championship in hand.
I'll tell you what, Super Crazy will have his hands full, however, against a guy that's as tough as they come in the Cruiserweight division.
And weighing in at 75 pounds, Nunzio.
And Nunzio accompanied by, his sometimes tag partner, his enforcer, Vito.
Obviously, Vito will not be involved in the Cruiserweight Championship match at No Way Out. That would just be silly.
Yeah, no, Vito does not look like a Cruiserweight, but you better look out for Vito outside of this ring. As Nunzio is in this ring, who knows what he's going to pull. Crowd ready for this one. We've had a tremendous show, but this will cap it off. The Mexicools. And in particular, Super Crazy taking on Nunzio.
That's exactly what Nunzio's going to want to do in this match. Keep Super Crazy off of his feet. Nunzio can mat wrestle with the best of them here in the WWE. If he allows Super Crazy to start that high-flying offense, then Nunzio will be in trouble.
Nunzio right now trying to keep it close. Trying to keep Matt wrestling in there. Look at great shot by Nunzio, but the counter by Super Crazy and the count to two. Nunzio almost got caught.
Yeah, just like that, Nunzio pulled off that jackknife, and then Super Crazy had it turned around. Super Crazy almost victorious.
I'll tell you what a great card coming up for No Way Out. Booker T versus Chris Benoit. Some say Booker T does not deserve to be the United States champion. We'll find out.
I wouldn't say it to his face, but this is it for Booker T. No substitution, no injuries. There is no way out for Booker T. Chris Benoit, the Rabid Wolverine. One more opportunity at the United States Championship.
How about Eminem versus Matt Hardy and a partner to be named yet?
I can't wait to see who Matt Hardy breaks out for No Way Out to take on Eminem.
Oh, monkey flip. And I'll tell you what, Nunzio took a shot to the back, Super Crazy with the cover. Is this it? No. Nunzio able to kick out.
And this is the pace that Super Crazy wants in this matchup.
Super Crazy, the high flyer right now. Well, had a hold of Nunzio. Nunzio able to counter out of that off the rope. Super Crazy catches him perfectly with that drop kick. Wow. Nunzio, look out, and he does. Super Crazy able to get back out of the ring, catches Nunzio anyway.
And there he goes.
Ooh. Wow.
Slingshot plancha over the top rope by Super Crazy.
I'll tell you what, if you want high-flying action, velocity is the place to be. The cover here, the count to two and two and a half. Super Crazy thought he had the victory, but no. Nunzio staggered outside of the ring. And Super Crazy knows it, looks to take advantage, and there Vito enters in.
Well, Super Crazy going for one too many high-risk maneuvers. The Pescado there, and Vito saw it come and push Nunzio out of the way.
Great anticipation by Vito helping Nunzio out. I'll tell you what, is this part of what we're going to see at No Way Out? I know there's going to be high-flying action.
Well, Vito's not even involved in the matchup. There's zero anticipation. Vito shouldn't be here, and he shouldn't have pushed Nunzio out of the way.
Nunzio with the cover here, trying to take advantage and complete it, but no, can't get it done. Super Crazy able to survive. I'll tell you what, speaking of surviving, what a match it's going to be. Lashley versus JBL, the wrestling god. Says he can beat anybody. Lashley has stepped up to the challenge. The cover here by Nunzio, almost hitting Super Crazy.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what happens. Bobby Lashley, JBL, wrestling god. Lashley's undefeated. These two men are going to collide big time at No Way Out.
And
and the emotional match of No Way Out. Rey Mysterio versus Randy Orton with the main event shot at WrestleMania on the line.
And we talked about that match earlier. So much on the line for both superstars. Randy Orton wants to go to WrestleMania, while Rey Mysterio wants to keep his spot for WrestleMania, and Mysterio wants to fight for the honor of Eddie Guerrero.
Now it looks like a form of maybe the camel clutch, some kind of chokehold on Super Crazy, and he looks like he's bleeding a little bit.
Yeah, Super Crazy busted open in the mouth.
Who will be busted in the mouth come No Way Out? The main event, The Undertaker versus the World Heavyweight Champion Kurt Angle. Who will prove to be the better man?
This is it. The winner of this match will go on to main event WrestleMania. The winner of this match will be the World Heavyweight Champion, the Dead Man, the Phenom, the legacy of The Undertaker and Kurt Angle. An Olympic gold medalist, a wrestling machine, two men on a mission. I can't wait to see what happens. Both men have been four-time WWE champions. Who's going to be the World Heavyweight Champion?
What a collision it's going to be. The Undertaker versus Kurt Angle. What a card it's going to be at No Way Out. And what a move that was by Super Crazy. Not still able to kick out at the last second.
I'll tell you what, you get near WrestleMania and The Undertaker does not lose. At the grandest stage of them all, the Dead Man, a perfect 13-0.
Oh, Nuzio looked like he lost a tooth. The elbow by Super Crazy shoots off the ropes. The cover. Oh, 2.5. Nuzio's still alive. Oh, man. Oh, look at that. Nuzio with a big time move. Super Crazy bouncing their head off the canvas.
That got toehold there, and now Nuzio looks to be in total control. However, if you look at Nuzio's eyes, he looks a little glazed over.
He does look a little glazed over. I'll tell you what, both superstars looking like they will have a shot at that Cruiserweight Championship if they compete at No Way Out.
Yeah, but how much is Nuzio and Super Crazy going to take out of each other right now on the line?
That's a great point. And right now, both superstars look spent. Nuzio on that top rope, taken down to the apron, and then Super Crazy.
Hey, Fido, watch Fido.
Fido once again getting into it. Oh! Super Crazy with the moonsault finish, and there it is! Super Crazy has some momentum heading into No Way Out.
And we'll see if Super Crazy or Psychosis can leave No Way Out as the Cruiserweight Champion.
We'll find out what will happen. But the main event, The Undertaker, the Phenom, taking on Kurt Angle, the World Heavyweight Champion, at No Way Out. He's Josh Matthews. I'm Steve Romero. We'll talk to you next week.
Sir, we promised you a great man.
Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
WrestleMania is running wild.
My God, what a
weighing in at 245 pounds, Vito!
Well, Super Crazy will be taking on Vito. Vito looks ready for business. Got the leather jacket going, donning the glasses. However, no hat. You got no hat today.
And that's not a jacket, it's a vest.
Jacket, vest, whatever. I think it was actually a jacket. He cut the sleeves off.
Well, Super Crazy and Vito, these two guys know each other very well. The Mexicools have teamed up and defeated Vito and his partner Nuncio on many occasions. We'll see if Vito can be more successful in singles competition.
Vito could get a little payback for their loss at the hands of the Mexicools. Will he get it done? I'll tell you, Josh, we mentioned about No Way Out and speeding towards WrestleMania, but what a great event it was at No Way Out.
Oh, no doubt about it. No Way Out, top to bottom, absolutely living up to and exceeding all expectations. One of the greatest main events in the history of the entire WWE.
And of course, you're talking about the Undertaker-Kurt Angle match. It was a star-studded night.
Tell you what, that entire main event, I was on the edge of my seat watching Kurt Angle and The Undertaker back and forth, you had no idea who was going to win, and then Kurt Angle actually defeating The Undertaker.
Unbelievable. Kurt Angle calculating pinpoint moves, as was The Undertaker as well, but it came out to be a tremendous main event. Right now, Super Crazy looking to take care of Vito, and the fans on his side as well. Gotta love that.
You know, Super Crazy will feed off of the great energy by these great SmackDown and Velocity fans.
Ooh. Super Crazy perhaps getting a little bit cocky, trying to come over that top rope and doing something spectacular, but Vito caught him. Crazy looks a little bit stunned.
Well, you're seeing some high flying by Super Crazy. That's why they call it high risk.
Super Crazy, the high flyer, Vito wanting to keep things more grounded, and right now, just grounding Super Crazy with that stiff clothesline. The cover here by Vito, there's two, and Super Crazy able to kick out. Suplex by Vito, and Vito right now in control. Vito's going to take a trip to the top rope.
And that's what I like, you saw Vito run to that top rope. He didn't take his time. Vito, with the quickness, got over to that top rope.
Vito, the cover, the count to two, Super Crazy, able to kick out. I'll tell you what, Vito trying to end this match early so he does not have to deal with that aerial assault of Super Crazy.
Oh, Vito's not getting paid by the hour, so he might as well try to end this match as quickly as possible.
I'll tell you what, a lot of things going on in the WWE as we head towards WrestleMania. It's been a great week this past week. And how about after their hellacious match? I mean, Randy Orton and Ray going at it for that spot at WrestleMania. Both talked to the audience this past week.
And Randy Orton's a jerk. How's that?
He is a jerk.
Randy Orton, absolutely. Just everything that he did leading up to No Way Out, everything after. I mean, Randy Orton just continues to go out there and disrespect Rey Mysterio and disrespect the life of Eddie Guerrero.
You've got to say that Randy Orton is a despicable person. And that's the bottom line. Vito coming up empty as he goes into the corner. Super Crazy feeding off the crowd. And a big back body drop by Super Crazy.
Now Super Crazy starting to feel it.
Ooh, the spinning kick by Super Crazy catches Vito perfectly. And Super Crazy's caught.
Hey, what? Super Crazy's in the zone right now.
Another big back body drop. Even more height on that one. Vito right now wondering what the heck's going on. Oh! Look at that move. Super Crazy almost picking up the victory.
Crucifix into a sunset flip.
Oh, look at this. Super Crazy got Vito pinned. Vito able to kick out.
Two great pinning combinations by Super Crazy. That a version of the Mahi Straw Cradle. And Vito able to escape both times.
And a power slam, scoop slam by Vito. Trying to turn the table on Super Crazy. He may have done so.
Well, Vito does have the power advantage over Super Crazy. One shot by Vito and Crazy may be out.
Vito trying to get fancy. Super Crazy read it. And he's able to get out of the way. Now Super Crazy reverses position and goes to the top rope.
You saw how quickly Crazy scaled up to that top rope.
Oh! And there it is! Super Crazy does it. Great move at the end to pick it up.
for crazy, using his speed to his advantage, scales that top rope, hits the missile drop kick, moonsault press, and super crazy is victorious.
Still to come on Velocity, Brian Kendrick, Paul London, and Funaki team up to take on Simon Dean and his proteges, the Gemini.
But up next, after their controversial match at No Way Out, Randy Orton and Rey Mysterio both need to get something off their chests. What's up to our great WWE fans across the UK? I'm Josh Matthews, and this is your WWE SmackDown WrestleMania Revenge Tour update. Huge news for our SmackDown fans in Belfast, Northern Ireland. The superstars of SmackDown will be live at the Odyssey Arena on Wednesday, April 26th. And one of the great matches you'll see, the United States Championship on the line. The world's strongest man, Mark Henry, challenging the man joining me right now, the current and reigning United States Champion, Chris Benoit. And Chris, what are your thoughts on facing the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, in Belfast?
Josh, I've been to Belfast many times before, and I look forward to coming back and successfully defending my U.S. title against the 6'4", 400-pound world's strongest man, Mark Henry. Those are very impressive credentials. But what's going to be even more impressive is when the Wolverine locks these hands together and makes you tap out.
For more information, as always, log on to WWE.com.
Xbox 360.
Well, I'll tell you what, Josh. The induction ceremony at WrestleMania 22. I mean, wow. That's all you can say is wow so far with the first two inductees.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Weighing in at 250 pounds, Silvan. And weighing in at 215 pounds, Sean Patrick.
Well, I know one superstar that cannot wait to get to WrestleMania, and that, my friends, is Rey Mysterio. Not only is Mysterio's best friend, Eddie Guerrero, going to be honored by being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame, Rey Mysterio is going to WrestleMania to compete for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Vous voyez rien.
What?
That is the problem with you Americans.
Uh-oh, here we go.
You don't see it. You don't realize. You don't realize. Shut up. You don't realize what the people from Quebec realize. That Sylvain is the future of the WWE. That Sylvain is a pioneer. And that Sylvain is a gift to wrestling.
Yep.
Exactly like my homeland, Quebec, is a gift to all of you. That's why I'm so proud to be the Quebec ambassador. Parce que peut-être que vous pensez que je suis le meilleur. Mais je vais vous montrer que je suis le meilleur.
Well, Sylvain apparently feels he is God's gift from Quebec. And letting everybody know, I don't think they care much for Sylvain. Now, Sylvain's stomping away at Sean Patrick. Sylvain coming out and trying to prove that he is the catch of the hour from Quebec. I guess the best thing you can say about Sylvain is he does know two languages. That's good for him. Take it, go back to Quebec. Sylvain right now all over Sean Patrick, who has been nothing but a cool for Sylvain to take out his aggression. Patrick into that barrier.
No doubt about
battle. We're seeing a very intense side of Sylvain right now. Sylvain not letting Sean Patrick breathe at all.
No, Sean Patrick, with the Americans on his side, it's not helping him much in this match. Sylvain really taking his aggressions out and doing so in a violent way.
See, I thought that Sean Patrick was Irish.
Well, yeah, but the American people are behind him.
If you say so.
That's what it sounds like to me. Sylvain has just offended everybody. I don't think it's so much more like that, but I didn't say hate Sylvain.
No, I might go in the ring right now and ask Sean Patrick what he thinks of Sylvain.
I don't think he cares for him much now. Of course, Sylvain, a former tag team champion, he has been on the winning side of things.
But if I left the announce booth, the table here, then I'd leave you by yourself and all hell would break loose.
That could be quite possible. It might. I don't think Sylvain likes you much.
I could care less. Sylvain right now. Sean Patrick in a very precarious situation.
Sylvain perhaps trying to get Patrick to tap out. And Patrick trying to rally to stay alive in this match. Sylvain imposing his will. Can Patrick stay alive?
Well, Sylvain right now just choking out Sean Patrick with his own arm.
Patrick Gable gets that vertical base, turn around and starts burying Sylvain. And then a deep shot to Sylvain, followed by a drop kick.
Sean Patrick getting tired of getting beat up in this match. Sometimes you got to poke the bigger man in the eyes. I don't care how big you are. Now poke the eye, take out anybody.
Sylvain coming right back, rushing into the corner, and Patrick has no momentum.
Sometimes I just go around poking big guys in the eyes for no reason.
Uh-oh. Patrick may have kicked off Sylvain. Look at the strength. He's like a sack of potatoes. Oh! And Sylvain looks to put it into this. Big time, the former Milo with the victory.
Here is your winner, Sylvain.
Pure strength right there by Sylvain. Snatching Sean Patrick out of midair, throwing him over his back. Hitting the TKO and this intense Sylvain is in victory.
Oh, guess what it's time for? Yeah, the Junior! This is awesome! I love you. This is great. The multi-color
Junior's match is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, standing 4 feet, 1 inch tall. Weighing in at 107 pounds, Mascarita Sangrada.
Did you see that leaping ability?
He's amazing. He's a blue chip athlete.
Oh, the little paws of the eye. He's got everything going.
Yeah.
And standing 3 foot, 10 inches tall, weighing in at 97 pounds, Suke.
I'm trying to figure out whose music I like better. Just gets you in a good mood, doesn't it? Suke, your favorite?
No, I like Mascarita Sagrada.
Do you?
He's undefeated.
Suke and Mascarita Sagrada.
All right, now it's time for my keys to victory.
Okay, let's hear them.
This all-important matchup, Mascarita Sagrada stands 4'1" tall. Suke is 3'10". And that's where Sagrada is just showing his athleticism.
Oh, look at this though. Suke with the quick cover.
For Suke to win, he's going to have to watch out for Mascarita Sagrada pointing up to the arena's ceiling. And not look. Well, let me finish. These are my keys to victory. These aren't Steve Romero's keys to victory.
Okay.
Nobody cares about your keys to victory.
Okay.
Let me finish. Don't look up. And don't get peed on either. I love it.
Fans across the pond, do we have some exciting news for you? The Raw and SmackDown superstars are heading your way this April. It all starts Thursday, the 20th of April, at the Birmingham NEC Arena in Birmingham. From there, the Raw superstars head to the sold-out Cardiff International Arena on Sunday, the 23rd of April. But fans, the WWE has added a new show on Monday, the 24th of April, also at the Cardiff International Arena.
Tuesday, the 25th of April, the Raw superstars get set to rock the Odyssey Arena in Belfast, Northern Ireland. The SmackDown superstars are coming your way Friday, the 21st of April, at the Newcastle Metro Radio Arena in Newcastle. And from there, the SmackDown superstars head to the Odyssey Arena in Belfast, Northern Ireland, on Wednesday, the 26th of April. for all the up-to-the-minute details on the SmackDown and Raw superstars on their way on the WrestleMania Revenge Tour, go to WWE.com. Don't do it! Don't do it! We got caught last week! Oh, man! I think it was a freedom. He pinched him in the neck. I think he pinched him in the nipple!
What do they call that?
A nipple pinch!
A nurple? I think it's called a nurple.
It's a dangerous maneuver.
Sagrada apparently staggered.
He's out on his feet.
And the cover here by Suke. Sagrada tosses Suke off like a ragdoll. I'll tell you what, SmackDown, you can see the juniors, you can see superstars, you can see the Cruiserweight division. And right now, I'll tell you the Cruiserweight division, Gregory Helms doing what he can to hold on to the title and cheating every chance he can get.
Gregory Helms is arrogant and cocky. He said he's the greatest Cruiserweight of all time, so our general manager, Theodore Long, is going to put Gregory Helms to the test. Hey, Gregory Helms, you got to face every single Cruiserweight on the SmackDown roster. And this past week, Gregory Helms cheated and defeated Psychosis.
Well, you know that every Cruiserweight will be gunning for Gregory Helms, and since coming over from Raw, Helms has talked trash every week.
I got a feeling that the luck of Gregory Helms, this cheating ability by Gregory Helms, is going to run out soon.
Certainly a lot going on. We also saw the talking Matt Hardy came up a little short thanks to your girl Melina.
Well, you know, whenever the tag team titles are on the line, Melina's going to get involved and ensure that M&M leave the arena as the tag team.
Yeah, like I said, your girl.
Look at that. Don't get caught. Oh, man.
Stop. Oh, and a hit to the face.
That's it.
Sagrada tossing off Suke.
Referee Chris K is assisting Suke.
Yeah, Chris, what are you doing in there? And that's what Sagrada's asking about. Come on.
You don't want to make Masquerita Sagrada upset, I tell you.
He better watch out for his kneecaps.
This guy walks around the locker room, Masquerita Sagrada, the superstar, is all just kind of pumped like the Red Sea.
He's all puffed up, you know, pumping out his chest. And look at the strength there. The cover by Sagrada.
Uh-oh.
Sagrada right now wondering which way is up. Getting tossed.
I honestly don't know what to say about what's happening right now in the ring. All I can say is I love it.
Suke tossed aside as he had a lock on Sagrada's backside. Oh, look at that. Look at that strength, huh? Come on. Oh, tripled it. The cover. There it is. Wow.
Here is your winner, Masquerita Sagrada.
Junior's rule.
Up next on Velocity, will one ring be enough to hold the likes of Chris Benoit, Lashley, and Rey Mysterio as they battle the impressive team of Finlay, JBL, and the legend killer, Randy Orton?
I'm the Boogeyman, and I'm coming to get you.
And it's time for the main event of six-man tag match.
Buddy, Simon Dean.
That's right, the Church of Simonology in the house.
People, my name is Simon Dean. And Simon says that tonight, the Gemini and I are going to demonstrate the power of my patented Simon system. Come on, people, look at these guys. Not only are they identical, but they are perfect, symmetrical, physical specimens created by me. Together with my patented Simon system, Simon says that we're invincible! Yeah!
Jerk. This guy, give me a break. Cut your hair, Simon, huh?
And making their way to the ring with a combined weight of 564 pounds, Paul London, Ryan Kendrick, and Funaki.
There is no doubt about it, the Gemini and Simon Dean will be facing a tough test, the high flyers, Paul London, Ryan Kendrick, along with Funaki.
I don't think Funaki knows what's going on right now. He's teaming up with the Daredevils, Paul London, and Brian Kendrick. Funaki, seeing those masks running down to the ring like that? Now, Funaki, you get used to it.
One thing is for certain, they're on his team. Three cruiserweights taking on some bigger men in the Gemini and Simon Dean.
So you know what Paul London and Brian Kendrick will be looking to do, and that's fly all over this arena and take out the Gemini.
Use as much as possible their quickness, their explosiveness, and the fact they can do just about anything in that ring. I'll tell you what's interesting about Paul London. Working out with him this past weekend, Josh, he does back workouts all by themselves, no other muscle group. He says that his spine needs to be protected, those back muscles are like shock absorbers. He really works out there to keep that spine intact.
Well, that's what all the superstars in the WWE need to do, and Paul London, especially the way he flies all over this arena.
Did you actually say you were working out with him, or you were watching him work out?
Can you believe it? I actually worked out mushroom stuff by London. I'm going to ignore that remark. London. Right, Gemini over the corner, tags to Funaki. Funaki coming off that rope and concentrating on that left arm.
I don't know about this strategy by Funaki and Paul London going after the arm of the Gemini. If it were me, I'd go after one of his legs. We'll see how it pans out.
Yeah, arm, leg, they both look thick as creep hooks, to be honest with you. I don't know if Bruce Lee's going to be able to get the Gemini.
The Gemini outweighs the size of people.
You know, I'm begging Simon Dean to at some point in time show us his muscular physique that he supposedly has. He's always covered up. I think he's got some extra hanging in there.
Simon Dean's got a six-pack like you've never seen before, Steve Romero.
That's true. I've never seen a six-pack.
I don't know where. I've never. Yeah. You look like a pear.
Thank you. I don't think he's got a six-pack. He gets bulldogged. And if Simon Dean gets bulldogged by Funaki, and right now, Funaki's trying to hit it quick.
Now watch out for the Gemini.
Gemini have been doing what they can do on the outside of the ring. And right now, a cheap shot, that gets Funaki hung up. Referee Charles Robinson too concerned with the team of Brian Kendrick and Paul London.
Well, referee Charles Robinson has a hard job here. How do you contain six superstars? I mean, it's going to break down at some point. It almost did right there.
Come on, folks, get up.
The cover here by the Gemini on Funaki. Count the two, Funaki able to kick out. I'll tell you what, six-man main event on SmackDown as well. And I'll tell you what, JBL this past week on SmackDown suffering a broken hand with a displaced bone after the incident with Chris Benoit on SmackDown.
Yeah, Chris Benoit just taking JBL's hand, drop kicking the stairs into JBL's hand, which was locked between the stairs and the ring post. I mean, how could JBL not break his hand?
You know, JBL, say what you want about him. He is a tough customer. The cover here by Gemini. And almost over, London makes the save on Funaki. Say what you want about JBL. He is a tough man, but you can't do anything when those bones are jostled about.
And for Rey Mysterio, who was also involved in that six-man tag team match.
Oh, the cover here. And that was quick. Almost over.
You can't go from any lower for Mysterio at No Way Out to any higher. With the conclusion of SmackDown this past week, Mysterio is now going on to WrestleMania Triple Threat to compete for the World Heavyweight Championship.
And he got the daily double. Not only that, he was able to pin JBL.
And now Rey Mysterio on a roll as we head towards the granddaddy of them all, WrestleMania 22.
I'll tell you what, couldn't happen to a nicer guy. A guy that works hard every time in the ring. He has a lot to get in the ring for. Rey Mysterio heading to the main event at WrestleMania 22.
And Funaki's trying to get out of the ring right now.
Yeah, I would do that. He's been in way too long. Funaki desperately needs a tag.
Exactly. I mean, if you're Funaki, Paul London, and Brian Kendrick, and you're sitting around, you know, talking about what you want to do in this matchup, the one thing you don't want to do is get locked up in the corner of the Gemini and Simon Dean.
Well, because you know this jerk's going to do cheap shots. Look at him with his, his stringy hair. He's obnoxious.
You're so jealous of Simon Dean.
He's so obnoxious. There's a shot of glass. Funaki goes downstairs to the breadbasket and hammering away on this jerk.
Come on, Phil.
Simon Dean alienates everybody in the arena when he comes in, except for you, that is.
I love Simon Dean. I'm on the Simon system. I have been for quite some time. I got nothing but positive things to say about Simon Dean and the Simon system.
Hey, look at Funaki firing up, giving a little bit to everybody in sight. I think this is the stuff that's unnecessary by Simon Dean. Do what you need to do. You don't have to rub your opponent's face in.
You do whatever you got to do. You want to take your knee and drive it into somebody's skull? You go right ahead. All these guys signed up for the same thing. You know what's going to happen once you step inside that ring. And Simon Dean is punishing Funaki.
Simon Dean trying to end things here. Funaki has got to get a tag here. He's been in for several minutes just getting abused. So many things going on in SmackDown. And it looks like now that the Boogeyman may have eyes on Booker T.
Hey, Booker T, watch out. The Boogeyman is coming to get you.
Yeah, you see, Michael Cole and Taz got a little dose of the worms this past week.
No one is safe from the Boogeyman. Everyone has a nightmare. It's just a question of when the Boogeyman is going to get you.
My nightmare is sitting next to me.
Your worst nightmare.
Exactly. In fact, I've got to sit next to me. Funaki off the road, face planted by the Gemini, and this could be it. The cover. Brian Kendrick and London come in to save the day.
Well, Funaki did make the tag to Brian Kendrick. Unfortunately, referee Charles Robinson did not see it. That's why Funaki is back in the ring, back getting punished by the Gemini and Simon Dean.
Well, like you said earlier in that shot, it's very hard for Charles Robinson to see everything that's going on.
Charles Robinson needs to be more prepared. He needs to know what's going on. This is ridiculous. What's enough?
Funaki just getting tapped in the ribs by Simon Dean, and this is more just rub your face in it. And Funaki takes exception, comes up with a couple of big right hands, and then a third.
This is preposterous. Funaki should not be in the ring right now. Funaki made the tag.
Oh, Funaki mustering up all the strength he has to come up with a counter to Simon Dean. And right now is the opening for Funaki. Come on. Uh-oh.
Not going to get there.
Yeah, it ain't going to happen. This thing's going to be over quick. Oh, Funaki resorts to the poke in the eye. Kendrick and London both come in. Look at the drop kick. By the tag team of London and Kendrick. Look at that. Who's the legal man in here? Oh, Simon Dean taking right off his feet. And now Simon Dean taking over that top rope. How about, how about that, Simon?
Brian Kendrick and Paul London doing everything in stereo, taking out the Gemini and Simon Dean.
Uh-oh, London gets caught and slammed outside the ring. A power slam by the Gemini, and now Brian Kendrick, who's giving up quite some weight in
slice
there.
Slice
spread number two ain't happening. Kendrick tossed aside like a rag doll. Recovered by Gemini, and that is it. Oh, man.
Here are your winners, Simon Dean.
Brian Kendrick and Funaki never got out of the box, completely shut down by the Gemini and Simon Dean.
Well, they pick up the victory. Hey, coming up this week on SmackDown, The Undertaker taking on Kurt Angle, the rematch. He's Josh Matthews, I'm Steve Romero. Talk to you next week.